Hello everyone, and welcome to today's video where we are joined by Matthew Hartley, who is the team leader for the BioImage Archive. Matthew, thank you for joining us today. And to get things started, can you give us a quick overview of your role here at EMBL-EBI?
Sure, thanks. So firstly, thanks for having me. So I lead the BioImage Archive, and that's a new deposition database set up by EMBL-EBI with the aim of making deposition of imaging data associated with publications routine. So the way it is in both genomics and structural biology and has been for a long time. So when people come to publish their results, to make sure that we have good reproducibility of those results, we usually ask people to deposit their raw data, and that's what we want to do for imaging. So imaging's a huge part of biological science, but the data resources have lagged a little bit behind those in structural biology and other areas. So we're aiming to change that with the BioImage Archive.
So I understand that before joining EMBL-EBI, you were a core facility scientist. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Sure. So I led the informatics platform at the Joyner Center, which is a research institute in plant and microbial science. So actually in some ways quite like EMBL, particularly the more experimental parts of EMBL. And my role there was to manage a team of core facility bioinformaticians and data experts to try to solve problems and provide internal services for the institute. So we handled lots of different types of data, and we handled lots of different types of analysis, and we also trained scientists and worked on quite a wide variety of different projects.
And what do you think were your biggest challenges when you were a core facility scientist?
So one of the biggest challenges is that bioinformatics is really a collection of lots of different fields, and they're all moving very quickly. So structural biology and genomics and imaging and chemical biology, they're all developing, and that means there are lots of new techniques coming online. Almost daily, it feels like. There's lots of new data types. Keeping up with the deluge of new things and ever-increasing volumes of data is very difficult. And it's particularly difficult, I think, if you're doing it on your own. So one of the things that very much helped me, and one of the key roles of EMBL-EBI overall, is that I attended a training course called Bioinformatics for Core Facility Managers here at EBI. And that was really good because it gave me, partly because it gave me an overview of the types of sort of project and problem that other facility managers were working on, but also because it helped with another of the challenges, which is that it can be quite isolating being a core facility manager in something like bioinformatics, because you're surrounded by experimental colleagues who don't quite understand what you do. You've got to manage a team, and you've got to balance their work and help them grow and develop. And having a group of people that had the same problems and the same challenges to discuss with was very helpful, I think, both from a practical work-focused point of view, but also to some extent emotionally, just understanding that you're not alone is very valuable.
I can imagine that isolation was really hard on core facility managers during the pandemic. Do you think that the working patterns are going to change in this post-pandemic world?
Yeah, it's a really good question. Certainly when the pandemic hit and we all moved to working online all of the time, there was a big sort of difficult adjustment phase. And one of the things about bioinformatics and sort of dry science in general is that we generally can work remotely, work from home a lot of the time because we don't need the direct lab access. But managing the sort of personal psychological aspect of that was a challenge. Now I think everybody, at least certainly the lab scientists, have mostly gone back to work as things were before the pandemic. But from the bioinformatics point of view, I think we've shown that we can do a lot of what we do remotely a lot of the time. So there isn't quite the same desire to be there physically present all the time. But there are a lot of challenges to how we manage sort of interpersonal relationships and balancing the challenges of getting to site and transportation, but also the challenges of working at home. So I think we're still finding a new equilibrium with what works remotely, what doesn't work remotely, what are sort of reasonable working patterns, how we make sure we keep the critical interactions with colleagues. So I think we're still finding our feet, but I don't think things will go back quite the way they were before, because we've sort of shown that a lot of things can work in a slightly different pattern.
Thank you. There's this amazing course here at EMBL-EBI, Managing a Bioinformatics Core Facility, and you've gone from being a participant to being one of the trainers. Did you find that some of the skills that you acquired during the course have been transferable to your current role here at EMBL-EBI?
Definitely. I think one of the major areas of overlap is that both roles involve managing teams of people who are both technical specialists but also scientists, and there's a lot of sort of balancing those two directions, which I learned quite a lot about in the core facilities course, because people have sort of different career paths and different ways in which they want to do things and develop, and that's again quite similar in the data provision role. The other side where there's a huge amount of overlap is the thinking about data and how to manage data itself, because very often I think core facilities are the sort of guardians of good data practice in their institution, and they're the team and the individuals that will end up with a lot of responsibility for managing data for their institution and training others in how to do this. And the course was good at sort of explaining what some of those challenges were and how other people had overcome them. And again, that's very much what I'm doing on a larger scale now, only with one specific data type, but still the sort of techniques and ways to think about that, I think, transfer very well.
So do you think there's enough support for people that wants to aim towards science service providing roles?
Yes, I think that's an area that's very much improving. I think one of the challenges is it's not necessarily obvious that these kind of roles exist if you're in a core facility, partly because service provision is quite a specialized role. And as I was talking about before, sometimes being in a core facility, you can be a little bit isolated, which again is why getting out and meeting people at events like the course is so good. I think big development that's helping in preparing people helping people make the transition to service and technology roles is EMBL's newish Arise program, which is a career accelerator fellowship, which provides support for a 3-year program, in a sense, learn about and transition into service and technology provision roles. And that's really good because there's a lot of training on that course, but also interesting opportunities to do technology development directly. So I think that's it's taking a little while to sort of get into the general consciousness, but that's going to be a big, big development.
I find it that also sometimes it is harder for professionals to head towards, say, service providing role if it is not well described in some sort of competency framework, which in this case we do have a profile for about core facility scientists, but they're not quite known. So the ISEB did come up have started working on different profiles, and they are right now working on the career progression, the different stages that the core facility scientists go through when heading on towards that career path. And well, finally, what would be one piece of advice that you would give to a core facility scientist?
I think probably the thing that will help most overall is find colleagues, find a mentor or people that can sort of understand the challenges that you're facing and support you in those. I think the technical side and the people management side will come with practice and with good training, like the course we've been talking about. But what's most critical is having people that you can sort of turn to and, you know, potentially unburden to. That's definitely what's helped me most.
All right. Well, Thank you, Matthew, for your time today. And thank you for watching this video. If you are interested in the managing a Bioinformatics Core Facility, the BioImage Archive, or any of the other resources that we mentioned today, you're going to find the link in the description. And thank you for watching.